That is a 7-liter, 425 brake horsepower Hemi engine, and the scraps of a Dodge Dart. Let's get it back to the garage. Are you with me? GMC Jimmy. Muy bien. I mean, Tio Oscar said his was a Chevy Blazer, but that's only because he thought it sounded better. I'll call in some transport.
Wonder those American collectors wanted this. It's a Viper. The ACR, I think. Aye, 8-liter V10. And almost impossible to keep the power on the road. But if you can, here, give me a hand.
It's an F40. I can't believe it. Help me get it out of here.
They found one of these things in Texas a few years back, but I had no idea there was another. That is a 250 GTO. We've hit the jackpot.
Wow, that is a piece of history. It's a Corvette, very early, might be 1953. Definitely a classic camioneta, Ford F-100. Let's take you back. Mm-hmm.
It's a Mustang. Oh, talk about famous cars. This is the one from... what's that movie with the detective? Hang on, it'll come to me.
Uy, looks to be in muy mala condición. Think I can get it working?
That was a trick question. I can get anything working.
BMW. Too old to be made in Mexico, though. We should take it to the taller so I can get a better look.
Victor's car.
Ford Escort. It has to be. Less than a quarter of the field made it to the finish line in Mexico City, but 5 out of top 10 were these things. That's how it got the name. It's a Renault Quatrel. That makes sense. In the 60s, there was a ban on imports, so the government allowed them to be built here.
Gracias for finding it.
Get a load of that. Looks like an old Baja truck. Oh, this thing's won more off-road races than you or I have had hot dinners.
I think we found it.
Finally! It's the XJR15. Rápido y raro. And a long way from its native habitat in the UK. I wonder how it got here.